So our research is focusing on a keystone predator in the state of New Hampshire, which when we have healthy predator populations, that really benefits the entire ecological community, including other animals and plants. Each one of these little vials represents one bobcat, and inside of there is the bobcat's DNA. And what we're actually doing is we're trying to figure out how related all of the bobcats that we have are. And with that, we'll be able to tell how well they're connected throughout the state. We can sort of incorporate that with landscape features such as waterways, roads, forest types, things like that, that might prevent or aid in bobcat dispersal across the state. So bobcats have a very rich and varied history in the state of New Hampshire. In the early 20th century, they were widespread throughout the state, and they were basically hunted and bountied to near extinction. In 1989, it became illegal for anyone to hunt or trap a bobcat, and it seems like in the past 25 years, their population has responded well. We see a lot more sightings of bobcats by the general public, and so it seems like the population is getting more robust. But the landscape is very different now than it was before when bobcats were very widespread. So we were interested to see if it's possible for bobcats to even have a healthy, well-connected population. Without the support of the Ag Experiment Station, this research would not even be possible. We're taking a very different approach to conservation, where we're using genetics, which is a very costly endeavor at times. So it's crucial. We can answer questions with genetics that we couldn't do with many of the previous methods that other conservationists have used. So it's crucial that we have that financial support to be able to conserve species like bobcat in New Hampshire.